diamonds in the rough. NFL Draft Diamonds. Time to shine.
Jimmy Williams with NFL Draft Diamonds, and today I have with me Eric Hansen, who's a defensive end out of Upper Iowa. How you doing, man?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you?
I'm doing good. Nice Friday for us. So, hey, can you just explain to the viewers a little bit about your overall career?
Yeah, so I started off playing football at Burlington Central. I played linebacker there for about 3 years, and then made the switch to DN my senior year. And that went pretty well. I was a little undersized. I was about 200 pounds playing DN. So when I got recruited out of high school, a lot of teams didn't really know where to put me at. They weren't sure if I should play linebacker or DN. So I got recruited by a decent amount of teams in the SIC, and I chose Upper Iowa. And after my freshman year at Upper Iowa, I ended up gaining 50 pounds. You know, and I played my freshman year there, but you know, I wasn't nearly as big as I probably should have been. But, you know, after that freshman year, gained that 50 pounds, and then kept gaining weight. Now I'm up to 260. But you know, my sophomore year went pretty well. Ended up starting, and then last season, my junior year, went really well. Had 12 and a half sacks and got on an All-American team, which was really nice. But you know, it's been really fun so far, and hopefully can add more to my career years to come.
Cool. And, you know, also on at least my notes here, I also had that you had 4 forced fumbles.
Yeah.
So kind of nice to be able to say that you've, you know, helped in the turnover game.
Yeah, that's true.
Eric, what's the best part about your game?
I would say, obviously, my pass rush, just the production I had last year kind of showed that. And I think it's only getting better. I've been working on my pass rush a lot this offseason. Went down to Chuck Smith in Georgia. He's a premier pass rushing coach. Trained with him, competed against a bunch of NFL guys. You know, really got some good moves down there and refined my skills a little bit. So I think I'm just getting better. I'm at the tip of my iceberg right now.
Cool. So, I mean, you were talking to me about how you're, you know, again, just trying to improve your game, you know, more or less just overall. What are some of your personal goals this particular year? Again, we are all hoping and praying that we actually have some football this season. So let's just ask that question. So what are your personal goals this season?
Well, I would say first and foremost, just win as many games with my team as possible. You know, I want to leave the program better than I found it. You know, add a lot more to that win column, and you know, just have fun doing it with my teammates. But personally, I just want to do better than I did last year. You know, help my team win as much as possible. You know, whatever it takes.
Gotcha. And like you said before, I mean, you had 12 and a half sacks this past season. And then, you know, again, hopefully we even get more than that, you know, whenever you get on the field this season. So hopefully you get 15 or more. Who knows?
Yep.
Eric, I also understand that you were a wrestler also when you were in high school. Yep. Can you just tell me a little bit about that experience and maybe how that actually translates to the football field?
Yeah, so I was a freshman in high school, and you know, I wanted to get better at football, and I was always told that you got to play multiple sports in order to be, you know, help with your football skills. So I decided to try wrestling. You know, I had a really good wrestling coach that was also a football coach that pushed me into the sport a little bit, you know, and it went really well for me. It helped me a ton with football, helped me with my footwork, helped me with hand fighting, you know, and just really, really helped. Also made me a lot more mentally tough wrestling, you know, with the cutting weight and the long practices and all day tournaments. You know, you can make it through a season of wrestling, you can make it through anything. So, and I ended up doing pretty well in it, made the state my senior year, you know, and that was, it was a really special moment. knowing that I really didn't play the sport all that long. You know, I started my freshman year and was able to still be successful. So that was a really good feeling.
Cool. And, you know, I was going to ask you to just give me a moment of your career. You know, tell me about maybe one of the most memorable plays so far that you've been a part of.
Yeah, it would have to be the Duluth game, just because we ended up beating them, which, you know, you always want to beat the team. And they were ranked, and it was a huge upset, and we took them out of the playoffs, because if they would beat us, they would have been in the playoffs. So it was just a really good feeling beating them. But the play that I felt like I did the best in that game was the very last sack, kind of put the nail in the coffin, you know, really just took the wind out of their sails. And that was, it was like one of the last plays of the game. I got the sack. Ended up being my third of the game. So honestly, all those sacks are really just really special, because I knew those all amounted to the win, helped contribute to the win.
Cool. So, I mean, you pretty much terrorized Duluth is basically what you're telling me.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, Eric, let's give a shout out to some of the people that have really helped mold and shape you over the years. I mean, talk to me and maybe about some of the coaches that have really influenced you, or maybe if there's a lesson that you learned from one of them that sticks with you today. Again, talk to me about some of your coaches.
Yeah, I would say most influential is my position coach, you know, because he's always hands on with me every day, you know, teaching me. And I'd say he's had a really big impact on my life, you know. Brought me in as a small, undersized DN as a freshman, you know, saw potential in me, you know, pushed me to gain weight, ended up gaining 60 pounds since I've been here. You know, that doesn't help. Like, that doesn't just happen, you know. Like, he helped a ton with that, you know, helped me with, you know, making sure I'm eating breakfast, making sure that I'm staying on the right track, you know, just helping me with the little things, teaching me life lessons, not to give up and not to make excuses. And just, he always demands that we play our best and, you know, don't make excuses. And I think that is going to stay with me for the rest of my life, you know. And I also say my dad's had a huge impact on me as well. You know, he was doing one-on-ones with me in the backyard when Corona was happening. You know, he wants to see me succeed just as much. And I feel like it's really special to have those people in my life.
Cool. Well, I mean, I think it's nice that you have somebody, even if it's your pops, that you're going one-on-one with right now. I know for some guys, they're able to get on campus and even, you know, work out with some of their teammates, but you got to take what you can get. You know, sometimes it's your dad, sometimes it's your brother, you know, if you've got like a, you know, 130 pound sister, whatever, you know. So, I mean, you got to take what you're given. But, hey, Eric, as we begin to wrap up, I want to ask you, why do you play football?
I just love the team aspect of it. I just like that bond that's created playing football. You know, it's everybody on my team, they're my brothers, you know, like we do anything for each other. And I just, it's crazy how a sport can create that tight of a bond between individuals that aren't related by blood. You know, I just think that's really special. And, you know, it's something that I'm going to really miss when my time's up. Hopefully not for a long time, though. But, I mean, I also just love the physical aspect of it, being able to take out your aggression on a quarterback, running back, offensive lineman, and it's legal, you know. You can only do that for so long, you know, and I just think I really enjoy that. It's something I'm hopefully can do for a while.
Yeah, cool. I mean, again, it's not like you can go to, like, the local Walmart and tackle the first person you see, so – I think it's obviously something that people love. I mean, the violence of the game. Eric, give me your final pitch to a professional team. You know, why should they draft you, sign you? What do you bring as a teammate?
Yeah, I would tell them that stats don't lie, film doesn't lie. You know, you watch the film, look at the stats. You know, I'm one of the best. I mean, I think that they're also going to get a hardworking individual. I don't skip workouts. I do extra work. You know, I make sure that I'm working harder than everybody else in our conference, you know, in the nation. You know, I'm looking to be that number one absolute best in everything that I do. no matter what it is. You know, I'm really competitive too. So I just feel like that's overall just molded me into a successful football player. And that's what they're going to get.
Cool. Well, Eric, this has been good just sitting with you, talking about, you know, football and life and stuff. I really appreciate our time together. Again, this is Eric Hansen. He is defensive end out of Upper Iowa, 6'3", 260 pounds, was an All-American last year with 12 and a half sacks. Expect good things from him. Thank you, Eric.
Thanks for having me.